Good day, and welcome to my video part two. I'm Professor Maniac, and I am again very thankful for those who have volunteered and provided so much information that has helped me work on this particular project. Day by day, some of the mysteries of the coral gardens are being solved. Fundamentally, geometry is the key to understanding what's going on at coral gardens. The platonic solids are but some of the symbols and the geometric shapes that are used within coral gardens. Yesterday I learned, to my great surprise, that Ed's flywheel, his magnetic flywheel, is part of the sacred geometries. I discovered this fact on the spiraloflight.com website. Ed's work is part of the electromagnetic field of the human Merkaba. And if you compare that to my work with the Sweet 16 coil, you'll see that the geometric shapes are quite similar. In comparison, Marco Rodin's work compares to the torus in the 13 sacred geometries. By all means, go ahead and pause this video if you need to in order to read the information that I've laid out in this particular video. Hans Kohler is about one person or resource that you can use to find information about over-unity systems. Another gentleman, the late, great Stan Myers, had over 25 different patents to his name. It is claimed that some of his systems produced over 1,700% in efficiency in terms of over-unity devices or the return on investment for energy put in to energy taken out. I truly believe that a combination of technical designs based on a whole host of folks over the years will contribute to the future of our over-unity energy devices. Ed Leedskalnin's magnetic generator is part of the sacred geometries and therefore has a great potential for success. I truly believe, just as with Marco Rodin's coil, that the Sweet 16 coil will lead us into the future in terms of the availability of renewables with regards to over-unity devices. Let's all continue to work together so that we can have a better energy future.